This question of the strongest candidate reminds me of the queen in Snow White, who was so fond of asking, mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest of them all? And so I think now that we ask, mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the strongest of them all? And since my good friend Tom Merritt isn't here, I'm going to pick on him a little bit. And since he came to the race, he's kind of like claimed that he's the strongest candidate and time is short. And he's our best chance of beating Scott Walker. And I could probably give a speech for him because I've heard it so much. And since on occasion he's borrowed some of my lines, maybe I can borrow his. But the mirror on the wall takes the longer view. And the mirror knows that this race is not about who can get to 48 fastest, but who can get to 51 by June 5th. And this election is going to be decided by those 2 or 3% of undecided people, many of whom live in western and northern Wisconsin. And northern and western Wisconsin is a contested area. Races are won or lost by 2 or 3 percentage points. That's who determines who wins or loses. In 2010, I won with a little over 50%. Now, at the same time, that was 2 percentage points more than Russ and 3 percentage points more than my good friend Tom. And without that 3 percentage points, the Wisconsin 14 would not have been. Ooh. I provide the strongest contrast to Governor Scott Walker. Yes. And when those dairy farmers finish their chores on June 5th and go to the polls, they will think about Scott Walker, who has been a lifelong political office holder. And they will think of Kathleen Weinhau, who's been a dairy farmer, who shares their experiences, who's gotten up at 5 o'clock in the morning and done the chores, who's gotten slapped in the face by those cows' tails, who knows the world from that other perspective. Now, to get to 51, we have to have those farmers. Because before answering our question, that mirror on the wall is going to ask, who are those farmers more likely to vote for? Because we know that Scott Walker cannot lose both the teachers and the farmers. And the mirror took careful note of the fact that the governor, when he started his campaign, started it on a dairy farm in western Wisconsin. So the question of the recall, why should we fire this governor? Well, if you look at the history of the recall, and you may know that I've written about this, and be glad to take a look at what I've written on my website, kathleenbynot.org. When I worked with the Legislative Reference Bureau to go back in time to look at the actual documents, and what we learned is that the principle of recalling the governor is based on a speedy remedy to remove an official who is not giving satisfaction to the voters.
Yeah.
And I'm finished.